Still overseas, it's calmer, but critically low on supplies. That's how New Caledonians looking after 5 days of violent protests over electoral changes pushed by France. Five are now dead, the latest another police officer, and arrests are into the hundreds. Thousands of French forces have been flown in to bring the Pacific Territory back under control. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever reports.
If not yet a civil war, this looks like the aftermath of one. To restore calm, France is flooding its Pacific territory with police and armed forces. 2,700 soon on the ground, hundreds more en route, and creating an air bridge for critical supplies. Because in New Caledonia, the situation is critical, with many supermarkets ransacked, destroyed or burned to the ground. Those with any food left are overwhelmed.
I've been to one of the shops to try and get a bit more food and there's nothing left.
Facing scenes like this, Kiwi PhD student Barbara has about a week of food left. Hospitals here too desperate for help. There's no point people coming here, this doctor says. We don't have the resources to treat anyone. Petrol's running low too, but that's not the biggest travel concern.
The road is one of the biggest issues. The road to the airport is about 40 minutes from Noumea. And it's currently still closed and dangerous to travel on.
Roadblocks and riots. New Caledonia's indigenous Kanaks are protesting proposed electoral changes they say will marginalise them more. But it's just a spark reigniting a decades-long struggle. They're 40% of the population, less wealthy, less healthy than the French migrant majority. This leader of one of the multiple pro-independence parties was in Paris, fighting to stop the electoral changes when the violence broke out.
We feel like we're shouting in a void, shouting in a void. Now things are exploding.
But France's president cancelling plans for video talks because leaders of the various groups reportedly won't talk to each other. Dozens of the Kiwis stuck here are meeting most days, sharing information and hope that New Zealand will come to their rescue.
So I've heard whisperings of Air Force intervention, New Zealand Air Force intervention, and I hope those might be true or at least on the cards, because I think that could be a really important option for a lot of the people here.
What we're doing is monitoring the situation. As you can see, it's a pretty dynamic situation. Our real message is we want to actually urge de-escalation. It's important that the parties get together, negotiate, and are able to actually find a pathway to peace and stability, and then we can deal with the situation as well.
Meaning a nervous wait for stranded Kiwis.
I just really want to get home.
With Noumea Airport closed until Tuesday next week.
Well, Barbara is with me now. Barb, how's the wider Pacific reacting to what's going on?
Oh, they're disturbed, unimpressed that it's actually got to this. And to be honest, not really that surprised. In 2016, New Caledonia and also French Polynesia became part of a full member of the Pacific Islands Forum. I was there and there were some reservations behind the scenes. And that's because, of course, those two countries are driven by France. Self-determination and indigenous rights are very, very important. Important to the Pacific, and that includes Kanak rights. And so the Prime Minister of the Cook Islands, Mark Brown, who's the chair of the Pacific Islands Forum, put out a very strong statement, and he says all parties need to get to the table and go back to the principles and the sentiments of the Noumea Accord, which is about sharing power. Now that sounds easier said than done, Wendy, but something sustainable needs to happen. Otherwise, you know, sending in troops and police and so forth, that may sort out some of the law and order issues, but it's really just a plaster on a very long festering sore. So something really has to happen, and the Pacific Islands Forum is offering a safe space for that too.
Thanks, Barb. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever.